And I'm really glad to be with all of you today. It's very nice to see you all. And thank you for taking out time today for this session. I'll try and finish this session in the next 2 hours. I know there is an audio constraint, but if at any time you want to ask me any questions or you want to stop in between, please feel free to use the chat box. Okay, great. So I hope you all know about me. I'm Shivani and I run an organization called Positive Vibes Consulting. I've had about a 17-year stint in the corporates. I have been an HR professional, worked in a couple of corporates in India as well as abroad in the Middle East. And since 2016, I have started this venture of mine, which is called Positive Vibes Consulting. It is an HR and training consulting firm. We are now 4 years old and based out of Gurgaon and working with corporates and providing mentorship programs and courses to individuals, professionals as well. So before we start today's session, I want you all to do a small activity. You all have notepads with you, I can see. You all have notepads, right? Now on the notepad, just take a minute, okay? And think of one person that you love the most in this world and write down his or her name. So one person that you really love the most in this world, you have to write his or her name on the notepad. Are you done? Thumbs up, thumbs down. When you are done, say thumbs up. Okay. Now I want you people, all those people to raise their hands who have written their own name. Is there anyone who have written their own name? No one. Anybody? One person. Who? Is that a male or a female? If it is a male, thumbs up. If it is a female, thumbs down. Female? Male. A female? A woman? So one out of so many people have written their name.
Madam, we are all male. Woman here.
Oh, I can see someone standing at the background. So I thought he...
No.
Okay, so one person has written the name, right? Written their own name. See, this is, and can I ask you why? Why your name did not come in your mind when I asked you this question, that who is it that you love the most in this world? Because this is how we women are wired. We always think of others first and ourselves later on. Yes or no? Yes or no? We always think of others first and we think of ourselves at a later date. We don't even think of ourselves. Agar main second time aapse poochti ki acha, write another person that you love the most, aap phir kisi aur ka naam likhte, aap apna naam phir bhi nahi likhte. Am I right or wrong? Right or wrong? Right. So we have to understand, first of all, that the most lasting relationship that I have is with myself. Other relationships will come and go. The one person with whom I will live till my death is myself. So when I only put myself on the back burner and say that there is someone else in this world that I love the most, how will I expect people to keep me on the forefront or to love me when I refuse to love myself? Agree or not?
Yes.
पहले खुद को प्यार करना सीखे ना हम, फिर बाकियों को प्यार करेंगे, तभी तो प्यार कर पाएंगे किसी और को. So today, let us see how our relationship is with ourselves. Let us evaluate the quality and health of this relationship. Now ask yourself this question, ki jab aap subah uthti hain, when you wake up in the morning, are these questions, you know, the ones that come to your mind? Do I feel glad to be who I am or what I am? Do I like the person that I am? Do I like myself? Do I feel good about myself? In other words, kya main apni favorite hoon? Kya main apni favorite hoon? Aur agar inme se kisi bhi sawal ka jawab no hai, then it means that we have some serious work to do on ourselves before we start reforming the world. If I don't have a good relationship with myself, how can I have a good relationship with anyone else? I struggle in my relationships with other people because mera khud ka relationship with myself is not good. If I don't have the capability to love myself, how can I expect others to love me? If I don't have love in myself, if I don't love myself, how will I give it to anyone else? You can't pour from an empty vessel. Ek khali glass mein se aap pani kaise de sakte hai jab us glass mein kuch hai hi nahi to. Samajh rahe aap? So today, we are going to learn to appreciate and love ourselves. That is going to be the first part of this session today. We often have a tendency to live like victims. Hum victim badi jaldi ban jate hain. Aap victim nahi hain. You are what you choose to be. Aapke paas life mein hamesha do options hoti hain. Ya to aap victim ban jaiye ya phir aap strong baniye. When life throws lemons at you, you can either take the sourness and the bitterness of the lemons and crib about how bitter the lemons are, or you can add your sugar and water into it and make a tasty lemonade. Choice is completely yours. Completely yours. No one else's. Ab humse jab koi hame bure shabd bolta hai, if somebody disrespects us or says bad words to us, we feel bad. Hai na? Why? जब हम किसी की डिसरिस्पेक्ट करते हैं तो हम उनको बोलते हैं डोंट टेक इट पर्सनली. लेकिन जब हमारी बारी आती है कोई हमसे डिसरिस्पेक्ट करता है तो हम कहते हैं ऑफ कोर्स आई विल टेक पर्सनली, हाउ डेयर ही से दैट टू मी. होता है कि नहीं? दूसरों को हम बोलते हैं डोंट फील बैड, इट्स नॉट अबाउट यू. अपने आप को हम बोलते हैं इट इज अबाउट मी, हाउ कैन आई नॉट फील बैड. This is because we have a separate conversation with ourselves and a separate conversation with the outside world. And this is also because we look at others to validate our personality. Hum chahte hain ki log hamare bare mein acha bole. Hamara apna jo self worth hai wo is pe dependent hota hai ki log mere bare mein acha bole, iska matlab main achhi hu. We need a validation from them. We need them to tell us that we are good. And if they say, no, you are not good, you are bad, then we feel bad. But problem here is ki it is not their fault. They haven't done anything. It is us who have allowed them to do it to us, who have allowed them to make us feel bad. It is us who have mentally resigned to their opinion. And we have made ourselves vulnerable. So usually, when someone says something to us, hota kya hai? Jab koi hame kuch bure words bolta hai, hum kya karte hain? We let it, you know, go into our brain. Hum sunte hain usko. Kaan se hamare brain mein jata hai. Brain se hamare heart mein jata hai because we have emotions. We are human beings. And if we don't like it, if we don't like what has been said, it comes out in the form of tears from our eyes. Aisa hi hota hai na? Kisi ne kuch bura bola hame, humne suna kaano se, apne mind mein register kiya, kyunki hum human beings hain, hamare dil ko bura laga because we have emotions in ourselves. Aur acha nahi laga to wo cheez tears ke through hamari aankhon se bahar nikal ke aayi. We felt bad, we felt horrible, we felt pathetic, right? Now let's understand why did this happen in the first place. Kyun hua ye? because I allowed it to enter into my brain. I allowed my brain to process it, and then my emotions took over. So what I need to do is, I need to create such a strong barrier here, outside my brain, the barrier of self-love and self-worth, that no matter what anybody says to me, I love myself, I will not let those crappy words go inside my brain. But I can create that barrier only and only if I have a strong relationship of love with myself. Isliye zaruri hai apne aap ko pyar karna. Because I know who I am. I know what my strengths are. I also know what my weaknesses are. I don't need someone to tell me because no one knows me better than I know myself. Agar ye कॉन्सेप्ट हमारे दिमाग में क्लियर है तो हमारा ये जो बैरियर है ये इतना स्ट्रॉन्ग बन जाएगा कि जो जिसको बोलना है, नो मैटर व्हाट हार्श वर्ड एनीबडी सेज, दे विल कोलाइड विद दिस बैरियर एंड दे विल बी स्टॉप्ड फ्रॉम एंटरिंग आवर सिस्टम एंड अफेक्टिंग आवरसेल्व्स. सो व्हेन आई अलाउ पीपल टू जज माय सेल्फ वर्थ एंड सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट एंड इफ दे हैव नथिंग गुड टू से टू मी, आई फील बैड. बट इफ आई हैव दिस बैरियर हियर, okay, if I have this barrier of self-love, self-worth, and self-appreciation, no matter what anybody says, will not matter to me. And tell me one thing, why do we not have this self-love for ourselves? Kyunki hame pata hi nahi hai ki hamari life mein humne kitni achievements kari hai. We take our lives for granted. अब आप लोग देखिए, आप इस कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम में बैठे हैं, सब लोग आप इस कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम में बैठे हैं क्योंकि आप इस कंपनी में काम करते हैं. इट्स अ वेरी गुड कंपनी दैट यू आर वर्किंग फॉर. बीइंग अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस कंपनी इज एन अचीवमेंट. नॉट एवरी, कितने लोग हैं मुझे बताइए जो इस कंपनी में आ पाते हैं? इट हैज सच अ रिग्रेस सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस. कितने लोग बाहर हैं जो आज की डेट में हु आर स्ट्रगलिंग टू फाइंड अ जॉब और हु हैव लॉस्ट देयर जॉब्स? तो ये आपकी एक बहुत बड़ी अचीवमेंट है कि आप इस कंपनी में काम कर रहे हैं, अपने बलबूते पे आए हैं इस कंपनी में, अपनी कैपेबिलिटी के बेसिस पे काम कर रहे हैं. नोबडी हैज डन एनी फेवर टू यू. व्हाई डू यू अंडरमाइन दैट? व्हाई डू यू फॉरगेट दैट? इससे पहले आपने पढ़ाई की होगी, यू मस्ट हैव वन सम एक्कोलेड्स इन योर स्कूल एंड कॉलेज, बट वी फॉरगेट दैट. वी फॉरगेट टू अप्रिशिएट आवरसेल्व्स. दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई वी डोंट लव आवरसेल्व्स. वी फॉरगेट एक्चुअली, बिकॉज हम वायर्ड ही इस तरह से हैं कि अपनी अचीवमेंट्स तो पीछे रह जाती हैं, लेकिन बाकी सबकी अचीवमेंट्स आपको जरूर याद होगा. आपके भाई के कॉलेज में कितने मार्क्स आए थे, या उसने टॉप किया था या नहीं किया था, या आपके हस्बैंड की क्या अचीवमेंट्स रही हैं उनके करियर में. लेकिन जब अपनी बात आती है तो हम भूल जाते हैं, इसलिए फिर हम अपना नाम नहीं लिख पाते जब कोई पूछता है कि किसको सबसे ज्यादा प्यार करते हो. आई होप यू ऑल आर ओके विद हिंदी. इज इट ओके इफ आई यूज हिंदी इन बिटवीन? या ओके, ग्रेट. सो आज हम सीखेंगे, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न, how are we going to make this barrier of self love? आज हम अपने आप से प्यार करना सीखेंगे. सीखना है सबको? Yes, no. सीखना है सबको? चलो फिर खड़े हो जाते हैं सब लोग. Everybody, let's stand up. Let's stand up. I won't stand because if I stand, you won't be able to see me. Everyone, stand up. Let's move a little. Okay. Everyone, close your eyes, and at the top of your voice, bilkul zor se, don't worry about people in the office, this is your time, this is your place, okay? At the top of your voice, zor se, aap ye shabd bole mere saath, jo main bol rahi hoon, mere peeche dohraye isko. I love myself. Say that. जोर से बोले, आई लव माई सेल्फ, आई एम प्राउड ऑफ माई सेल्फ. से इट अगेन, आई एम प्राउड ऑफ माई सेल्फ. फील दोज वर्ड्स, फील दोज वर्ड्स वेन यू से इट. आई लव बींग विद माई सेल्फ. Feel the words when you are saying, I love being with myself. Say it again. Main apni favorite hoon. Teen baar bolo isko. Main apni favorite hoon. Zor se bolo. Main apni favorite hoon. Zor se, teen baar. Excellent. Now open your eyes. Give the loudest clap to yourself. Loudest, as loud as you can be. Let those hands move. Loudest clap to yourselves. Give a pat on your back. We don't need anyone else to give a pat on our backs. Give a pat to your back and hug yourself really tight. Hug yourself really tight. Nice. Now sit down. Now tell me, how did that feel? If you felt good, do a thumbs up. If you felt bad, do a thumbs down. If you felt okay, do a side thumb. How did you feel? You felt nice about yourself. I'm glad to see those thumbs up. Now imagine, ये तो आपने एक बार किया है आज, पहली बार. Imagine अगर आप ये रोज करें. Imagine करें अगर आप ये रोज अपने साथ करें. सुबह उठ के बाथरूम में या कहीं भी, डोंट केयर अबाउट व्हाट अदर्स वुड थिंक ऑफ यू, जस्ट स्टैंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर एंड डू दिस एवरी डे. इमेजिन व्हाट इट विल डू टू योर सेल्फ वर्थ, योर बिलीफ इन योर सेल्फ. सो इज दैट अ प्रॉमिस दैट आई हैव फ्रॉम यू? विल वी डू इट एवरी डे? विल वी डू दीज थिंग्स एवरी डे? दीज थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स एवरी डे से टू योर सेल्फ. वी डोंट नीड एनी वन एल्स टू से दीज थिंग्स टू अस. वो बैरियर बनाना है हमें, और वो बैरियर हम खुद ही बनाएंगे, कोई और नहीं बनाएगा हमारे लिए. ओके, ग्रेट. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट अनदर थिंग, एंड आई एम इन फैक्ट गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट इट टू यू थ्रू एन एक्टिविटी. आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट समथिंग नोन एज द जार ऑफ लाइफ. अब अ लॉट ऑफ अस फील दैट वी स्पेंड सो मच टाइम इन डूइंग आवर वर्क, बट वी स्टिल डोंट फील कि हमने कुछ अचीव किया है. ऐसा होता है क्या आप लोगों के साथ कि हम करते तो बहुत कुछ है लेकिन वो सेंस ऑफ अचीवमेंट नहीं आता है? पता नहीं टाइम कहाँ चला जाता है. होता है ऐसा किसी के साथ? ये सिर्फ मेरे साथ ही होता है ऐसा? यस नो, यस नो, ओके, सम नो सम यस, ओके, ऑल राइट. मेरा मतलब कहने का है कि हम कभी सोचते हैं कि जिंदगी तेज रफ्तार से चले जा रही है लेकिन फिर भी लगता है कि कुछ पाया नहीं. बेसिकली ये बोल रही हूं मैं. अब वो हमें ऐसा इसलिए लगता है क्योंकि कई बार हमें खुद पता नहीं चलता कि हम अपना टाइम कहाँ लगा रहे हैं. सबके पास एक ही लाइफ है, सबके पास वही 24 घंटे हैं, लेकिन कौन उन 24 घंटों का क्या करता है, दैट इज वॉट डिफाइन्स what this person is going to achieve. What happens is, more often than not, we spend our time on small issues, cribbing about what we don't have in life. Mere paas ye nahi hai, mera aisa hona chahiye tha, mera waisa hona chahiye tha. Facebook sabse badi musibat. Wo acha, wo friend meri is holiday pe gayi, wo fir international holiday pe chali gayi, mujhe to kahin leke nahi jaate, हम तो कहीं जाते ही नहीं है. वो फिर निकल के आई बाहर, गर्ल्स गर्ल्स नाइट आउट पे, हमें तो अलाउड नहीं है नाइट आउट करना. बहुत सारा टाइम इनवेरिएबली हमारा इन चीजों में चला जाता है. तो अभी मैं जो आपको दिखाऊंगी, आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू एन एक्टिविटी, आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्प्ले एन एक्टिविटी टू यू. इट इज नोन एज द जार ऑफ लाइफ, वेयर आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू दैट how you spend your life depends on what you put into your life. Now let me show you here. I have some stuff here with me. Can you all see this? मेरे पास ये दो जार हैं, ठीक है? ये दो जार हैं मेरे. These are my jars of life. Okay? ये मेरी जिंदगी है, ये भी मेरी जिंदगी है. Okay? Now what do I have here? I have some apples. Okay? Think of these apples as the big things in your life, the important things in your life. When I say important things, it means things like your health, your relationships, your family, your spirituality, and the things that you truly, genuinely believe in doing. Things that are permanent. Aane jaane wali cheeze nahi, things that are permanent in your life. Okay? Apples connote the important things in your life. Now, I have some almonds with me as well. बादाम जो कि साइज में एप्पल से बहुत छोटे हैं. सो थिंक ऑफ दीज एलमंड्स एज थिंग्स विच आर रिलेटिवली लेस इंपॉर्टेंट एंड विच आर नॉट परमानेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर जॉब, योर हाउस, योर यू नो योर EMIs, etc., etc. दे आर इंपॉर्टेंट बट नॉट एज इंपॉर्टेंट एज द एप्पल्स, राइट? Relatively less permanent. ये आते जाते रहते हैं. Job भी आपकी change होती है, right? You have a different financial plan. जब आप 20 के होते हैं तो कुछ और finances होते हैं, 40 के होते हैं कुछ और होते हैं, 60 के होते हैं कुछ और होते हैं. तो financials भी आपके change होते रहते हैं, permanent नहीं रहते, right? And think of this. This is rice. Think of these rice as the most unimportant things in your life. Social media, gossiping, cribbing, thinking about why I don't have this and I don't have that. Okay? Now let us see this. This is my one jar. Okay? Ye mera ek jar hai. Now if I fill my life first with the rice of all the unimportant things that I do in my life, if I fill it up with this, then I move on to my job, etc. I fill it up with the almonds. And then I do go on to the big things in life. Can I accommodate all of them? Can I accommodate all of them in this jar? No, because my jar is full already with the things that I should not be spending any time on. Ab isko ulta karke dekhte hain. Let's go to the next other jar. Now, in this jar, I first decide to spend my time, maximum amount of time, on the things that are important to me, like my life, my family, my friends, my health, my spirituality, my hobbies, okay, my hobbies, and so on and so forth. Okay, so meri jo important priorities in life hain, wo maine already apni life mein bhar ke rakhi hain. Ab mere paas jagah bachti hai thodi, to main yahan pe job, money, EMI और जो भी मेरी लाइफ में टेम्प्ररी चीजें हैं उनकी बहुत जगह है मेरे पास, बहुत जगह है मेरे पास वो डालने के लिए. और अब अगर कोई जगह बचेगी तो उसमें शायद थोड़े से चावल मिक्स हो जाए. कहने का मतलब ये कि अपनी लाइफ में प्रायोरिटाइजेशन करना सीखिए. दिस एक्टिविटी हेल्प यू to understand how important it is for you to decide what you want to put in the jar of your life. If you decide to fill it up with unimportant things, small things, things that don't matter, cribbing, comparing, feeling bad, spending time on politics, whether it is kitchen politics or office politics. तो फिर जो हमारी बड़ी बड़ी चीजें हैं हमारी लाइफ में, हमारी रिलेशनशिप्स, हमारी फैमिली, हमारी हेल्थ, ऑल दिस विल गो फॉर अ टॉस, क्योंकि हमारे पास उन चीजों पे फोकस करने के लिए टाइम बचेगा ही नहीं. सो व्हाट यू पुट इन द जार ऑफ योर लाइफ डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ फुलफिलिंग योर लाइफ विल बी. हम बोलते हैं हमारे पास टाइम नहीं है एक्सरसाइज करने का, अपनी हेल्थ का ध्यान रखने का, लेकिन हमारे पास फेसबुक देखने का टाइम है, हमारे पास व्हाट्सएप पे चैट करने का टाइम है. बिकॉज समवेयर वी डोंट प्रायोरिटाइज द टू. समवेयर इट्स मोर कंफर्टेबल टू लाई डाउन ऑन माई बेड एंड सी माई मोबाइल फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, बट उठ के पैदल चलना, सैर करना इज पुलिंग मी आउट ऑफ माई कंफर्ट जोन. तो ये एक और लेसन है जो आज हम सीखेंगे कि अपने आप को इस कंफर्ट जोन से बाहर कैसे निकालें. अब मैं आपसे बात करना चाहूंगी जो आज का मेरा टॉपिक है. लेट मी कम टू दैट नाउ. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ब्रेकिंग द ग्लास सीलिंग, वुमेन इन लीडरशिप रोल. अब ये ग्लास सीलिंग है क्या? अब बचपन में हमने एक कहानी सुनी होगी सबने, या अपने बच्चों को सुनाई होगी, सिंड्रेला की कहानी. सुनिए सबने सिंड्रेला की कहानी, थम्स अप. सबने सुनी होगी है ना, या बच्चों को सुनाई होगी. तो एंड में सिंड्रेला की हैप्पीनेस किस पे डिपेंड करती है कि अगर वो प्रिंस जो है, वो जो ग्लास स्लिपर लेके घूम रहा है सब जगह पे, सबके घर में, अगर वो उसमें फिट आ गया उसका पैर, तो देन ही विल टेक सिंड्रेला टू हिज पैलेस एंड मैरी हर. सो द चैलेंज इन हर लाइफ इज टू बी एबल टू फिट इन दैट ग्लास स्लिपर, बिकॉज इफ शी फिट्स इन दैट ग्लास स्लिपर, शी विल गेट ऑल द हैप्पीनेस. हर फ्यूचर हैप्पीनेस डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर शी फिट्स इन द ग्लास स्लिपर और नॉट. Because her happiness is dependent on the prince and not on her. तो आज की डेट में हमें इस ग्लास स्लिपर में फिट नहीं होना, बल्कि हमें जो ग्लास सीलिंग हमारे ऊपर है उसको तोड़ के आगे बढ़ना है. अब ये ग्लास सीलिंग होती क्या है? Let's understand that. The Oxford Dictionary definition of the word glass ceiling is an invisible or unacknowledged barrier to the advancement in a profession, specifically affecting women to rise beyond a level in the hierarchy. These are typically the barriers in the careers of high achieving women. And why I have chosen this topic today, you know, to speak to you is that I hope that through my experiences, I can present to you the tools that you need to break the glass ceiling and live your dream. Because I have been, witnessing this glass ceiling in my career, and I have been able to break it and reach where I am today. And I want to share my life lessons with you. You need to aim higher because you know you can. You have to be fearless and focused. You don't have to copy anyone. You have to become the best version of yourself. That is exactly what I did in my life. Every step I aimed higher and I reached here. Now let me tell you my story first. How did that happen? I grew up in a small town called Chandigarh in Punjab. Sabne suna hoga Chandigarh ke bare mein. Jahan pe society is largely patriarchal and it is conservative. I belong to a very conservative Punjabi family. So when I got through my MBA, I got through Symbiosis Pune, and this is in the year 2004. So my relatives advised my father to not let me go to Pune and instead do my MBA from a local college, because to them MBA was a degree that I needed to get a good groom. कि मेरे marriage prospects अच्छे हो जाएंगे अगर मेरे पास MBA degree होगी तो. So all my relatives advised my father to not send me out, to stay in a hostel, keep me at home under control, and MBA तो किसी भी कॉलेज से हो सकती है. सो माई फर्स्ट चैलेंज इन माई लाइफ दैट आई फेस्ड वॉज दैट आई वॉज वेरी सीरियस अबाउट हैविंग अ कॉर्पोरेट करियर. आई वॉन्टेड टू हैव एन आइडेंटिटी ऑफ माई ओन. आई डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू बी नोन एज समवन्स वाइफ. सो दिस वॉज माई फर्स्ट चैलेंज, कन्विंसिंग माई फादर टू अलाउ मी टू स्टडी आउटसाइड एंड स्टे इन अ हॉस्टल. एंड आई डिड इट. इट वॉज वेरी टफ बट आई डिड इट. Lot of resilience. I had to prove myself. And he told me that if you face any problem, it just remember it was your decision. I did not push you into it. So when I went to the hostel, you know, like a girl who comes from a small town into a big city, and there are people from all over India who are studying there. Some are very, very exposed because they've come from metros. So I developed a complex, an inferiority complex in college. I was not able to make friends there because I thought I'm coming from a, you know, a lower city. I didn't get the kind of exposure that they had. I never spoke in my class. Never. I was a very, very quiet student. And look at what I have become now. I've become a trainer. Bolna mera pesha hai. So this is what I faced in my college, but I could not go back to my father and tell him that, okay, I don't like it here. Can I come back? Because going back was not an option. Not only because he had told me that you cannot come back, but also because somewhere I had taken it on myself that this is my only chance to prove myself and to make a career for myself. If I don't want to be stuck cooking rotis in someone's kitchen for the rest of my life, this is my only opportunity. The second challenge came when I got a campus placement in a company in Delhi. But as part of my training, because I was in HR, so the company said that all HR trainees, the management trainees, they all first go to the factory location, which is in Kota in Rajasthan, a small place in Rajasthan. And a factory, as you all know, you all have worked, I'm sure you know, in a factory is usually dominated by males. Male employees hi zyada hote hain wahan pe. So again, the challenge was, to allow my family to go to a place, stay in a guest house alone, being the only female there in the middle of so many men. But once I realized that if I do not undergo this training, my career would be seriously affected. Because if I want to learn the grassroots of HR, I have to have an IR stint, an industrial relations stint, jo mujhe factory mein hi milega. To wo hota hai na, jab aap kisi cheez ko shiddat se chahte ho, to puri kainat jud jati hai aapko wo cheez dene mein. So the same thing happened. I had to convince my father. I had to make him talk to the HR head and to make him, realize that it's a safe place and they'll take good care of me and go on. So this is how I began my career. What I'm trying to share with you is that this glass ceiling exists for every woman. If you look at me today, you will feel that, it's been for her, there is no glass ceiling, but you don't know what I have gone through in my past. Glass ceiling exists for the most successful women in corporate India as well. Anywhere, even outside of India. I have worked in the Middle East. वहां पे भी ग्लास सीलिंग होती है. बहुत बैरियर्स होते हैं. सोसाइटियल बैरियर्स होते हैं. पेट्रियार्कल बैरियर्स होते हैं. जेंडर बायस होता है. बहुत सारी कंपनीज में होता है. आई हैव ऑल्सो अंडरगॉन इट. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम टूल्स. आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर सम ऑफ माई एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड लर्निंग्स दैट हैव मेड मी व्हाट आई एम टुडे, दैट हैव हेल्प्ड मी इन ब्रेक द ग्लास सीलिंग्स. My first, lesson or my first tool that I'd like to talk about is stay focused and have a strong will to do well in life. आपके पास एक ब्रह्मास्त्र है. ब्रह्मास्त्र समझते हैं सब. अभी सबने रामायण महाभारत सबने देखी होगी लॉकडाउन में. ब्रह्मास्त्र समझते हैं सब. Everybody understands what is it? Yeah? Okay. आप सबके पास एक ब्रह्मास्त्र है. वो है आपकी विल, आपकी इच्छा. लेकिन बहुत बार हम उस ब्रह्मास्त्र को यूज ही नहीं करते, उसको हम दबा के रखते हैं. एंड वी लेट एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस टेक ओवर अस. डोंट ट्रीट योर सेल्फ और योर करियर एज अ साइड किक. व्हेन आई गॉट मैरिड, पीपल इन माय इन-लॉज फैमिली थॉट दैट आई डू अ जॉब टू स्टे बिजी और टू पास माय टाइम टिल द टाइम आई डोंट हैव चिल्ड्रन. तो हेंस द क्वालिटी ऑफ जॉब डिड नॉट मैटर टू देम. व्हाट मैटर्ड वाज द टाइमिंग्स, 9 से 5. अब वो 5 का अगर किसी दिन 7 बज गया तो दे फेल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट why I need to put in so much of hard work and do a job which according to them is a way to pass my time. But for me, it was not a time pass. It was my career, my passion, and a strong will to do well in life. So gradually they got the message because they could see my focus, my dedication, and my intent to succeed in life. तो बड़ा आसान होता है दूसरों पे ब्लेम डालना फॉर द फेलियर्स इन आर करियर. हम ये नहीं कर पाए क्योंकि हस्बैंड ऐसे हैं, हम ये नहीं कर पाए क्योंकि इन लॉज ऐसे हैं. बट अपने आप से एक क्वेश्चन पूछिए, हैव यू बीन फोकस्ड इनफ टू टेक योर करियर सीरियसली, टू चेज योर ड्रीम्स पैशनेटली एंड नॉट जस्ट ट्रीटेड इट लाइक अ साइड किक, समथिंग दैट यू आर डूइंग ऑन द साइड. इफ यू आर फोकस्ड टू डू वेल इन लाइफ, others will see that hunger in you to succeed and do well in your career sooner or later. A lot of times it's only us who allow people to ride over our desires and our wills and practically our lives. Don't let that happen to you. Treat your career as the only opportunity that you have to prove yourself. Not to anyone else, but to yourself. Dream big. अपने सपनों को पंख दीजिए. Don't chain your dreams. Chase them. Be who you want to be, not what someone else dictates you to be. I know it is easier said than done. मैं बोल रही हूँ, बोलना आसान है. लेकिन मैं इसलिए बोल रही हूँ क्योंकि I have gone through this and I know it is very tough. बहुत मुश्किल है. But fight for your dreams. Because no one else is going to fight for your dreams except for you. कोई और आपके dreams के लिए लड़ाई नहीं करेगा, आप ही कर पाएंगे अगर आप सच में कुछ अचीव करना चाहते हैं लाइफ में. Now, my second lesson here is to grab the opportunities that come your way. Now, opportunities are things that don't come every day. But do we really realize the value of opportunities? हम समझते हैं कि opportunity है क्या, उसका महत्व क्या है. मैं आपको एक example देती हूँ अपनी life से ही. In the year 2010, I had a great and a very high paying job with one of the multinational companies in Gurgaon. We had bought a house, my husband and I, and life seemed to be settled. We were planning for a family. Just then, an opportunity knocked our door and my husband got a very good opportunity with KPMG in Qatar, Middle East. Now, he got a job, I did not get a job. So the decision was, should we go, should we not go? On top of that, again, ek to ye jo relatives hote hain, ye har occasion mein aa jate hain. Punjabis mein to bahut hi hota hai ke कुछ भी होता है आपकी लाइफ में, आपके रिलेटिव जरूर आते हैं अपने सजेशंस देने के लिए. आई डोंट नो इफ इट हैपेंस विद यू पीपल और नॉट, बट इट हैपेंस अ लॉट हियर. सो अगेन आवर रिलेटिव्स हैड देयर ओन ओपिनियंस. दे सेड दे डिस्करेज्ड अस टू टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी बिकॉज इट वुड मीन गोइंग टू अ रिलेटिवली लेसर नोन कंट्री एंड गिविंग अप व्हाट वी हैड इन इंडिया. मुझे एडवाइस किया कि तुम्हारा इतना अच्छा करियर चल रहा है यहाँ, इसको छोड़ के क्यों जाओगे. But then I realized that that I wanted him to take this opportunity and he wanted me to go with him. So we grabbed this opportunity because international opportunities don't come every day. I left my job and I moved with him because I had the confidence in my capability and I knew that sooner or later I will find a job based on my competence. That was the confidence that I had in myself. And within 3 months, believe me, I found a really good job. And that job gave me a lot of recognition. I got an award from the managing partner of this company to successfully lead and manage their most prestigious project in the office of Her Highness, the ruling queen of Qatar. I was leading that project. Imagine the kind of recognition that I got. But what did I do? I took a risk of moving out of India. It was a calculated risk. I'm not saying that take risks in life. It's not wise to take wild risks in life. One should always take a calculated and educated risk in life. It is worth it. Giving up my cushy job and moving to a new geography, new culture, new people was not easy. But I gave up. I came out of my comfort zone. I grabbed the opportunity and I worked so hard that I squeezed the most of that opportunity. Then again in 2015, when we decided to come back to India with my two-year-old daughter, I again got an opportunity with my first organization, DCM Shriram, to head the HR function of their largest business. This was after a two-year sabbatical that I had taken on the birth of my daughter. Now, again, I could have rejected this opportunity, fearing the change again, managing a, you know, a child and traveling to work and, you know, all the setup, all the dilemma that all us, you know, working women go through. But I grabbed it. And again, I squeezed the maximum out of it. This was my drive, my ambition. And let me tell you, ladies, there is nothing wrong in being ambitious. If men can be ambitious, why can't women be ambitious? So understand that you have never arrived in life fully if you don't make the most of the opportunities coming your way. Like I said, calculated and educated risks in life need to be taken to be able to learn and grow. If you don't explore, you will remain stagnant. You know, I work with PSUs. I work with all the three oil companies, Indian Oil, HPC, and Bharat Petroleum. And when I do programs for women there, I see so many women giving up promotions and growth because they have to move to a new place. Unko bola jata hai ki aap agar is jagah pe transfer le lenge, to aapko, you know, you will get promoted. I've seen many of them rejecting it. Now, sometimes what happens, it is difficult to move out. There are genuine reasons that we can't move out. But sometimes we women feel guilty of thinking about ourselves and our careers. Now, tell me, if a male employee is told that he will be promoted only if he accepts a transfer, would he refuse? Dekha hai kabhi aapne? Would he refuse ki nahi, main nahi transfer lunga? He would expect that his wife moves with him. Is that right or wrong? देखा है किसी मेल को कोई ट्रांसफर प्रमोशन रिजेक्ट करते हुए क्योंकि ट्रांसफर लेनी पड़ेगी? नहीं देखा मैंने तो आज तक किसी को नहीं देखा. तो हम क्यों ऐसा फील करते हैं? बिकॉज वी टेक इट ऑन ourselves टू फील responsible फॉर everyone अराउंड us, बट us. हम अपने ऊपर वो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ले लेते हैं और फिर अगर हम उस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी को नहीं निभा पाते, अगर हम अपने बारे में सोचते हैं तो हम गिल्टी फील करते हैं. देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन थिंकिंग अबाउट योर सेल्फ. देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग. एनी डिस्कशन, एनीथिंग, एनी व्यूज हियर? आई कैन सी पीपल टॉकिंग. यू वांट टू पुट ऑन
शिवानी, देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन इन द चैट.
Yeah, what's the question?
So it says, had this been opposite, where you got an opportunity and your husband did not, would he allow you to move?
So my first question is that, why do I need to ask for an allowance? Did he ask me? I think they'll write they're writing. Are they right? Is anyone writing? Okay, I can see someone typing. Thank you. you wanted him to take the opportunity of Qatar, would he be accompanying you to Qatar? Well, now again, he checked with me whether I am okay to move to Qatar or not, right? And that was the decision that I made, that yes, I'm open to moving with you, okay? Had I got this opportunity of a job in Qatar, at that time, I did not have a child. Would I be okay to move? I personally would be okay to move. Would he be okay to move or not? That's something that I have to manage. Now, that's a choice that I have to make. That's a choice that I have to make. If he does not want to move with me, what do I want to do? Do I still want to go? Or do I want to stay back? But given my career ambition, I know I would have gone. Even if for a brief period of time, I would have gone and come back. And I would have made sure that he understands my ambition. If people, if your spouses are not able to understand your
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, there's a lot of echo.
Yeah, I asked this question. It's echoing, I guess.
Yes.
Better I write it in chat.
Sorry, a lot of echo. Couldn't hear you. So you are asking me that if he had not, is this what you're asking me, that if he would not have allowed me to go, would I have still gone? Okay. You managed to quit. Would he quit? Okay, let me give you an example. When we had to come back to India in 2015 from Qatar, there were some personal reasons. My parents were not well, which is why we decided to move back. I was the first one to get an opportunity in India. He did not have a job. He still moved with me. That's the difference. Because, you know, sometimes you feel, you know, okay, someone has been lucky enough to have a supporting spouse. But I would say that it's not luck all the time. You also have to set priorities and make your, you know, ambitions in life very clear to your partner. See, my husband and my family knows today that if I have a career, it makes me truly happy. And if I am happy, they are also happy. I cannot keep them happy if I am not happy myself. ये रियलाइज कराना बहुत जरूरी है. इट्स नॉट ओनली करियर, इट्स एनीथिंग एल्स. यू लाइक टू डांस बट योर हस्बैंड डजंट वांट यू टू डू इट. बट हैव यू रियली मेड हिम रियलाइज दैट इफ यू डोंट डू इट, इफ यू डोंट परस्यू योर पैशन, यू विल नॉट बी अ हैप्पी इंडिविजुअल. एंड इन रिटर्न हाउ कैन यू गिव हिम हैप्पीनेस? इवन टुडे माय वर्किंग स्केड्यूल इन द करियर दैट आई एम इन is very, you know, very, very haphazard. But does that mean I don't spend time with my husband and my family? No. I do spend time with them. I do spend time with my daughter. I do spend time with my husband. But I'm very serious about my work also. And they know it. So expectations are set that yes, there is a time that will go into making the career. But yes, there is a time which is there for family as well. So what you are saying is that means good communication is an important key. Of course it is an important key. Communication is the basis of any relationship that you have. But a lot of that communication has to be from your side as well. You can't expect a person to keep understanding you all the time. Aisa nahi hota. Ye Cinderella world nahi hai. You also have to make certain sacrifices for the person. Now, I quit my job and went to Qatar with him because I wanted to support him. So when I got an opportunity as head of HR with DCM Shriram in 2015, he quit his job and he came with me because somewhere he realized that I have given up a flourishing career because of him and I took a risk. Wo to acha ho gaya ki job mil gayi mujhe wahan pe, nahi milti mujhe agar job. I would have done something, I know that. Chahe job nahi hota, main freelancing kar leti. But then it was a risk that I took. Did I answer your question? Yeah, okay. So moving on. The third thing which follows from the second thing is to be guilt-free. अपने आप को guilty मानना छोड़ दीजिए. Learn to put yourself as a priority. It's okay to think of yourself and your career because it is what defines you. It is what helps you make your individual identity rather than being known as someone's wife, someone's daughter, someone's daughter-in-law, and so on. If for your career, you need to make adjustments in your personal life, do not hesitate to do it. Children will grow up. Husbands can manage without you. In-laws can manage without you. They were managing before you got married or not? They were managing, right? Before you came into the family. So it's all about setting the expectations right. Like I said, if you can't be happy, you can't, as the lady of the house, spread happiness. नहीं कर सकते आप लेडी ऑफ द हाउस हैं. जब लेडी ऑफ द हाउस ही खुश नहीं होगी तो घर में खुशी आएगी कहां से? बाकी सबको कहां से खुशी मिलेगी? इसलिए एक्सपेक्टेशन सही सेट करिए, चाहे वो आपके जॉब को लेकर हैं, चाहे वो आपके करियर को लेकर हैं, चाहे वो आपके पैशंस को लेकर हैं. सेट द एक्सपेक्टेशंस राइट. नंबर फोर, अलाउ योरसेल्फ टू ड्रीम बिग. Most of the times, we do not allow our imagination to go beyond our normal routine. We do not think of the future because we are uncomfortable with change as human beings. Change achha nahi lagta. Hum ek comfort zone mein aa jaate hain aur us comfort zone se nikalna hamare liye ek bahut bada challenge ban jata hai. Sometimes we are too rigid to let our dreams evolve. Loosen up. What we don't understand is that change is the only constant in life. Parivartan hi sthir hai. The only constant in life. I'll again give you a very, an example from my life. In 2015, I was the head of HR for DCM Shriram. In 2016, I decided to leave. Because I wanted to do something on my own. I wanted to become an entrepreneur. Now, I was at a very fat pay package. People thought I'm crazy. Ye pagal ho gayi hai. Giving up a position of a head HR, you know, at a secure salary that comes at the end of the month. Every month, it keeps coming. Increment mila achha. Promotion hone wali thi. Toh kyun chhod diya? People told me ke business karne ke liye choda hai. Purane time mein to jisko job nahi milta tha decent, wo business karta tha. Tum kyun business mein ja rahe ho? So people really discouraged me that don't leave your job. It's a safe, it's a secure job. You are doing well. Why leave it? Why give it all away? But I was very clear that I was very determined. I wanted to create something of my own because deep down in myself, I knew that I had the capability, the drive, and the passion to create and run an organization. I knew I would be able to do it. People did not have faith in my capability. People thought ke business to chalega nahi, phir ye gap ho jayega, phir job bhi nahi rahegi, aur achhi job nahi milegi, phir kam salary pe join karna padega. I said, it's a choice that I'm making. I'm okay to do it. At least let me try. Let me give it my best shot. Nahi hoga to nahi hoga. Then it's my choice. I'll be responsible for whatever comes out of it. Now, what happened when I became an entrepreneur, when I started this company, Positive Vibes Consulting? Ab corporate mein kya tha? I was head HR. I had a team of people working under me. But when I became an entrepreneur, I was my own secretary. I was my own assistant. I was my own peon, my office boy, everything. When I started, I had to face a lot of failures, rejection, people treating me badly. I used to approach people to give me work. They did not know who I am. So they used to, acha dekh lenge, aap kal phone kariyega, parso kariyega. Uske baad they used to stop my taking my calls, bang the phone on me. Now, I wasn't used to all that because I was a senior person. HR head ka phone to sab uthate hain, koi kaatta nahi hai. So it was a big shift for me. Very big shift. It was a jolt for me. But then I thought, okay, this is my decision only. Nobody asked me to do it. So what can I do now? So I took every rejection, every failure as a learning. And I worked extremely hard to become the best version of myself. And here I am today, from being an unknown trainer 4 years back. Today, I'm a part of the elite business world 40 under 40 club of achievers in the training space. So push yourself out of that comfort zone, because you do have such a tremendous potential to go far beyond where you are today. Hame pata bhi nahi hota hamare andar kitni potential hai. But hame comfort zone mein aa jate hain to hame dar lagta hai usse bahar nikalne ke liye. Hum ghabrate hain usse bahar nikalne ke liye. But itni potential hai aap sab mein. Har ek mein hoti hai potential. You just have to discover that star within yourself. Everyone has a star within themselves. Just have to nourish it and bring it out. And from this follows my next lesson, which is learn from your failures. We all feel bad when we fail. I told you I failed a lot of times when I became an entrepreneur. And it, believe me, it feels terrible. बहुत बुरा लगता है. अब मैं क्या करूं? बुरा तो मुझे लग रहा है. या तो I wallow in self-pity, cry on every shoulder that is available to me, blame people around me, blame my boss, blame my husband, blame my in-laws, or I decide to bounce back. So failure will come into your way. This is life. It's not a bed of roses. Sab kuch achha, beautiful nahi rahega. You will fail in the things that you have put your heart and soul in. ऐसा हुआ है कभी कि आपको फेलियर आपने देखा है कोई ऐसी चीज जिसपे आपने बहुत मेहनत करी है लेकिन फिर भी आपको कामयाबी नहीं मिली उसमें? ऐसा हुआ है कभी आपके साथ? बहुत लोगों के साथ हुआ है ऐसा. हम सब बड़े ही ऐसे हुए हैं. स्कूल कॉलेज में भी पढ़ के तो हम सब जाते थे. अब क्वेश्चन दूसरा आ गया तो हम क्या करें, है ना? तो ये तो पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ है. फेलियर तो पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ है. लेकिन इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू एनालाइज द रीजंस व्हाई यू फेल्ड. व्हाई डिड यू फेल? एनालाइज द रीजंस, एक्सेप्ट इट. बहुत बार हमारी प्रॉब्लम ये होती है कि हम फेलियर को एक्सेप्ट ही नहीं कर पाते. डिनायल में चले जाते हैं हम कि ऐसा मेरे साथ कैसे हो सकता है. उसका उसकी प्रॉब्लम थी, उसको मैं अच्छी नहीं लगती, बॉस को मैं पसंद नहीं हूं, इसलिए मेरा प्रमोशन नहीं हुआ. हो सकता है, देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट. लेकिन एक बार एनालाइज तो करके देखिए कि क्यों उसकी प्रमोशन हुई और मेरी क्यों नहीं हुई. सीखिए, कुछ ऐसा होगा उस इंसान में. देयर मस्ट बी समथिंग गुड अबाउट दैट पर्सन व्हिच यू नीड टू एक्सेप्ट एंड लर्न. सो पॉइंट आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक हियर इज दैट यू नीड टू एक्सेप्ट योर फेलियर्स. And you can, and believe me, you cannot completely taste true success if you have not experienced failure. गिर के उठने में जो मजा आता है वो गिरने वाले को ही पता होता है. चल रहे हैं तो चले जा रहे हैं हम, लेकिन अगर हम गिरे हैं, and if when we're able to get up, that is when you experience the true surreal sense of success. But it is important that you don't let that failure take the steam out of you and pull you further down. In fact, failures should push you to work hard, to get better at your job, accept your shortcomings and work on them. Failing is okay. It's okay to fail. There's nothing bad about failure. As I said, failing is required to experience the joys of success. So it's okay if you have failed. It's okay to feel bad if you have failed. But don't let that failure pull you down. Don't let that failure take the steam out of you. Any problem here? Anything? Any issue? Sorry, I can't hear what you all are saying. So I'm dependent on the chat. So if there's anything you want to communicate, please communicate on chat. Okay. Okay. Now, there's one more thing that I want to talk to you about. And that is, surround yourself with the right people. your friends, your family, your colleagues have a huge role to play in your success. Learn to recognize the people who truly feel happy with your success. People who enthuse you with energy, not the people who suck the energy out of you. Believe in the power of networking. What happens is, we women, a lot of times, we put networking at a back burner. Active networking karte hain hum log. Jaate hain hum networking events pe, kyunki hamare paas time hi nahi hota, hame ghar bhagna hota hai. Sunday, Saturday ko bhi hamare kaam khatam nahi hote. Even the online groups that we have, for which we don't have to go anywhere, even those we are not able to contribute much to, because we underestimate the power of networking as women. We underestimate it. But believe me, the power of networking is huge. During the course of networking, you may come across people who truly inspire you and guide you to chase your dreams, to think big, to stay positive, and most importantly, feel good about yourself. These are the people that you should surround yourself with, not the people who waste their and your time in criticizing others, gossiping, talking low of people, and generally complaining about everything in life. Hote aise log who are all the time just complaining. Matlab unko agar main bolti hu khuda bhi mil jaye to bolenge ki acha pehle kyun nahi mila, ab mil gaya to kya badi baat hai. Those kind of people. Those are the kind of people you should stay away from. Surround yourself with positive people. Surround yourself with people who will help you to succeed in your careers, in your professional life and personal life, both. Jab hum kisi positive insaan ke saath time spend karte hain, to hume achha lagta hai, right? Chahe wo insaan hume kuch na bole, but still, those vibes that come out of the person, we feel nice being with that person or talking to that person, because that person brings the good vibes in us, brings the best out of us. While when we talk to a person who is basically a negative person, to ek ghanta baat karne ke baad lagta hai yaar zindagi barbaad hai hamari. Kya ho raha hai hamari life mein? Why were we even on? Right? So again, important that surround yourself with the right kind of people. There is some noise here. One second, I'll put on. Okay. Now also understand that you cannot please everyone. हमें बड़ा अच्छा लगता है कि हम सबको खुश कर लें, चाहे वो हमारे बॉस हैं, चाहे वो हमारे बच्चे हैं, हमारे पति हैं, हमारे इन-लॉज हैं. We are always making an effort to please people. Accept the fact that no matter what you do, आप कुछ भी कर लो, however hard you work, there still will be people who will remain unhappy with you. ऐसा होगा ही होगा. आप चाहे जितनी मर्जी सेवा कर लें या फिर आप जितना मर्जी हार्ड वर्क कर लें ऑफिस में, there will be people who will remain unhappy with you. It's okay. It's their problem, not yours. Don't beat yourself to please others. You are living your life. And you should do things that will please you and not others. If they truly love you, they will be happy in your happiness and not expect you to give up your happiness to please them. So again, coming back to the point that I made, surround yourself with the right kind of people who are not just looking at you pleasing them, but who truly understand your ambitions, what you want from your life, and who encourage you to achieve what you want in your life. Sabko khush karna kisi ke bas ki baat nahi hai. And last but not the least, I want to tell you people, practice gratitude. Ye badi ek zaruri cheez hai, lekin hum bhul jaate hain isko. Gratitude ka matlab hota hai being grateful for what you have. हम नहीं देखते कि हमारे पास क्या है, हम ये देखते हैं कि हमारे पास क्या नहीं है, और इसीलिए जो 50% और जो हमारी प्रॉब्लम्स लाइफ में होती है वो इसी रीजन की वजह से होती है, दैट वी डू नॉट अप्रिशिएट व्हाट वी आर ब्लेस्ड विद. द वेरी फैक्ट दैट वी स्लीप एट नाइट अंडर अ प्रॉपर रूफ, वी स्लीप ऑन अ फुल स्टमक, वी हैव अ प्लेट फुल ऑफ फूड टू ईट बिफोर वी स्लीप, makes us much more fortunate than 50% of the people in this world. Do we even realize what a blessing that is? We wake up in the morning, all healthy, all our limbs working, body parts working. We don't realize that till we visit a hospital and we see suffering. Visit an old age home. You will see what helplessness looks like. But we consider these things as things that we take for granted. We don't consider ourselves to be blessed. Instead, hum comparison karenge. Uske paas badi gaadi hai, mere paas choti gaadi hai. Wo international vacation pe gayi, main is baar sirf domestic vacation pe gayi. उसकी प्रमोशन हो गई, मेरी प्रमोशन नहीं हुई. उसके हस्बैंड की सैलरी ज्यादा है, मेरे हस्बैंड की सैलरी कम है. व्हेन यू रियलाइज द अमाउंट ऑफ ब्लेसिंग्स दैट यू हैव हैड इन योर लाइफ, ऑल दीज थिंग्स विल बी इमटीरियल. दे विल बहुत छोटी चीजें हैं ये, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम यह है कि इन छोटी चीजों पे हम अपनी 50% से ज्यादा लाइफ लगा देते हैं, और इन्हीं चीजों को लेके हम दुखी रहते हैं, जबकि दुख करने वाली कोई बात ही नहीं है. हम अच्छी कंपनी में काम कर रहे हैं, हमें सैलरी मिलती है, हमें कोविड में हमारी जॉब लॉस नहीं हुई है, वी आर ऑल सिटिंग इन ऑफिस थैंकफुली. डू वी इवन फील हाउ ब्लेस्ड वी आर? सेंस द डेस्परेशन ऑफ पीपल हु आर आउट ऑफ जॉब्स, हु आर रनिंग देयर फैमिलीज, हु हैव टू पे ईएमआईज एवरी मंथ, who are supporting their parents, their siblings. Imagine the helplessness of those people. All that they want is a job. They will not ask ki mujhe itna CTC de do aur mujhe itni badi gaadi de do. Unko sirf job chahiye ki wo apna ghar chala sake. To agar aap bahar dekhenge aapko lagega ki aap bahut blessed hain, lekin ye jo blessings hain inko hum taken for granted le lete hain. We are not thankful for it. Before we do, after this, I'm going to make you do an activity. But before we do an activity, I want to share a video with you of how you can actually overcome, how these small things that we all crib about really don't matter in life. Let me just share a video with you all. Just one moment, please. Can you all see my screen? Can you all see my screen? Thumbs up, thumbs down? You can.
I was 18 years old when I got married. I belonged to a very conservative family, a Baloch family, where good daughters never say no to their parents. My father wanted me to get married. And all I said was, if that makes you happy, I'll say yes. And of course, it was never a happy marriage. Just about after 2 years of getting married, about 9 years ago, I met a car accident. Somehow my husband fell asleep and the car fell in the ditch. He managed to jump out, saved himself. I'm happy for him. But I stayed inside the car and I sustained a lot of injuries. The list is a bit long. Radius ulna of my right arm were fractured. The wrist was fractured. Shoulder bone and collarbone were fractured. My whole rib cage got fractured. But that injury that changed me and my life completely was the spine injury. Many people came to rescue. They gave me CPR. They dragged me out of the car. And while they were dragging me out, I got the complete transection of my spinal cord. Those 2.5 months in the hospital were dreadful. I was at the verge of despair. One day, doctor came to me and he said, well, I heard that you wanted to be an artist, but you ended up being a housewife. I have a bad news for you. You won't be able to paint again. Next day, doctor came to me and said, your spine injury is so bad. You won't be able to walk again. I took a deep breath and I said, it's all right. Next day, doctor came to me and said, because of your spine injury and the fixation that you have in your back, you won't be able to give birth to a child again. That day, I was devastated. I started to question my existence. Why am I even alive? So what kept me going was, one day I asked my brothers, I know I have a deformed hand, but I'm tired of looking at these white walls in the hospital and wearing these white scrubs. Bring me some colors, bring me some small canvas. I want to paint. So the very first painting I made was on my deathbed, where I painted for the very first time. What an amazing therapy it was. Without uttering a single word, I could paint my heart out. I could share my story. People used to come and say, what lovely painting, so much color. Nobody could see the grief in it, only I could. And that day I decided that I'm going to live life for myself. I am not going to be that perfect person for someone. I am just going to take this moment and I will make it perfect for myself. And I'm going to fight my fears. So I wrote down one by one all those fears. And I decided that I'm going to overcome these fears one at a time. You know what was my biggest fear? Divorce. But the day I decided that this is nothing but my fear, I liberated myself by setting him free. And I made myself emotionally so strong that the day I got the news that he's getting married, I sent him a text that I'm so happy for you and I wish you all the best. And he knows that I pray for him today. Number two was, I won't be able to be a mother again. And that was quite devastating for me. But then I realized there are so many children in the world, all they want is acceptance. So there is no point of crying, just go and adopt one. And that's what I did. I gave my name in different organizations, different orphanages, and I waited patiently. 2 years later, I got this call from a very small city in Pakistan. I got a call and they said, are you Muniba Mazari? There is a baby boy and would you like to adopt? I could literally feel the labor pain. I said, yes, yes, I am going to adopt him. I am coming to take him. And that day, I was 2 years old, 2 days old, and today he's 6. Do you know when you end up being on the wheelchair, what's the most painful thing? People think that they will not be accepted by the people because we, in the world of perfect people, are imperfects. So I decided to appear more in public. I started to paint. I have done a lot of modeling campaigns. I decided that I'm going to join the national TV of Pakistan as an anchor person. I became the national goodwill ambassador for UN Women Pakistan. And now I speak for the rights of women, children. I was featured in BBC 100 Women for 2015. I'm one of the first 30 under 30 for 2016. So when you accept yourself the way you are, the world recognizes you. It all starts from within. We have this amazing fantasy about life. This is how things should work. This is my plan. It should go as per my plan. If that doesn't happen, we give up. I never wanted to be on the wheelchair. Never thought of being on. This life is a test and a trial, and tests are never supposed to be easy. So when you are expecting ease from life and life gives you lemons, then you make the lemonade and then do not blame life for that. It is okay to be scared. It is okay to cry. Everything is okay, but giving up should not be an option. They always say that failure is not an option. Failure should be an option because when you fail, you get up and then you fail and then you get up and that keeps you going. Embrace each and every breath that you are taking. Celebrate your life. Live it. Don't die before your death. Real happiness lies in gratitude. So be grateful, be alive, and live every moment.
Okay, so I hope that video made you realize how blessed we all are when we see the suffering around us, when we see people like this lady, Muniba Mazari. It's truly inspirational. We forget our own worries. We see what people have gone through and still come out of it strongly. Like she said, why say failure is not an option? Failure is an option. And like I said, you fail, the true fruit of success can only be tasted if you fail and you fall. Because when you fall, you get up, and then you fall again, you again get up, and that keeps you going. Right? So today, we are going to do one last thing, which is an activity that you all have to do. I wish we could talk, but it's okay. I think we can still do this activity. You all have notepads with you, right? I want you people to draw a flower, okay? Let me just show what kind of flower I'm saying. One second. I'm just sharing my screen with you. Just give me a moment, please. Can you see my screen? Yeah. Just draw a flower like this on your notepads with a circle in the middle and the petals around it. It's okay if you can't draw the stem and the leaves, that's fine. All I want is the flower. Are we done or are we still drawing? Okay, you can take 2 more minutes. Okay, I hope we all have drawn the flower. Now, this is a flower of gratitude. Okay. This is your flower of gratitude, where I want you to write in the middle, in the circle, I want you to write things that I am thankful for. Just write it there, things that I am thankful for. And once you have written it, things that I am thankful for, on the petals around this circle, write the things, introspect and write the things that you truly are grateful for. The things that you consider in your life as blessings. Put all of that in these petals. So I'll give you about 5-7 minutes. You can take your time, think about all the things that you are grateful for in life, and let's put them down on this flower of gratitude. Is it clear what you need to do? I'll repeat again. In the middle of the circle, you have to write things that I am grateful for, and in the petals of the flower, you have to write, you have to think and write of all the things that you are truly grateful for in your lives. Take about 5-7 minutes to do this activity, please. Are we done? Are we done? Yes, no, I can't hear you all. Yes, we are all done. Okay. I can't hear you, otherwise I would have asked you to share some of the things, but if anyone would like to type it on chat, anybody, what are the things that you are grateful for? If you'd like to share. Anyone wants to share? The things that you are truly grateful for. Okay, if you don't want to share it, I would request you to take this gratitude flower, cut it out and paste it on your workstation so that tomorrow when you feel upset about the things that you don't have a look at this gratitude flower. Have a look at how many blessings have been bestowed on you. So take a cutout of this flower and put it either on your workstation or on your fridge or next to your bedside table, wherever you will see it every day. You will feel so blessed, and the problems that you have will be very small in nature. Okay, with that, I stop here. Now I am opening the house for questions that you may have. Questions that you people have. One of the questions that was told to me was around multitasking. Is that a question that you guys want to hear? Is that something that you want to know more about? How to multitask? You have to say something, either a hands up or a hands down. Okay, since this was a question that was asked, that how do we multitask? Now, let me tell you, when you say multitask, you mean to say doing too many things at the same time. Right? That is what you are saying is the definition of multitasking. But what I feel is that we, in reality, we can't do multitasking. What we do is shift tasking. What happens is, just imagine, you are sitting down and writing an email. Okay? If you just focus on writing that email, you will be able to finish it off in 5 minutes. But if you are typing an email, talking on the phone, listening to what your colleague is saying, okay, checking WhatsApp, the same email will take you 20 minutes to complete. Now, is that multitasking? That's not multitasking. That is shift tasking. You are shifting your focus from one activity to the other. Because as human beings, we do not have the capability in our brain to focus on multiple things together. I will do the call and then I'll start typing again. I will finish my conversation on WhatsApp, then type again. Right? So this is called shift tasking. What you are trying to ask, I think, is that how do we manage all the roles that we have to play as women? Am I right? I think that is probably your question, that how do we effectively manage all the roles that we have as women? Now, the answer to that question is prioritization. Have you prioritized what you want to do in life? Do you maintain a to-do list? Do you maintain a goal list for yourself every morning? Now, when I say to-do list, I don't just mean the official work that you are supposed to do. Do you make a schedule for yourself for the day, including your personal life? This is the time I will wake up. This is the time I will spend on yoga or meditation. This is the time I will spend on cooking food. This is the time I will go to office. This is what I will do in office today. These are the 5 things that I will do in office today. This is the time when I will finish and leave. and this is the time when I will spend with my children. Do we prioritize? If we are prioritizing it, we will write it down as a to-do, an activity to do during the day, and we will be able to achieve it. Problem is, we do not prioritize. Have you ever thought that, okay, workout or exercise is an important part of my life, so I have to do it? Most of us leave it optional. Time milega to main kar lungi. और जब हम किसी चीज के बारे में ऐसे सोचते हैं कि टाइम मिलेगा हम कर लेंगे, उसके लिए कभी टाइम नहीं मिलता, कभी नहीं मिलेगा. आपको टाइम निकालना पड़ता है. इट्स जस्ट द वे वी डू एट ऑफिस, द वर्क व्हाट वी डू एट ऑफिस. व्हेन वी थिंक दैट दिस इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट, लेट मी डू दिस फर्स्ट. ये काम जब टाइम मिलेगा तब कर लेंगे, वो टाइम कभी नहीं मिलता. सो द ओनली वे टू मैनेज ऑल योर you know, commitments of being a mother, of being a sister, of being a daughter, of being a working woman, of being a wife, of being a daughter-in-law, is that you have to prioritize what are the things that are most important for you and write that down every day. I still do it. I don't have my diary here. I would have shown you. Every morning, I make a schedule. The previous night, I make a schedule of my timetable. What am I going to do in the morning? What am I going to cook for food? Because I waste a lot of time in thinking what to cook. So what am I going to cook in the morning? What time am I going to start work? What time is my exercise? ठीक है, उसमें आगे पीछे होता है. I'm not saying that we go by the rule. होता है, definitely होता है. Work sometimes takes a lot of time because कुछ priority है, कुछ emergency है. That's fine. Once in a while is fine. But every day, if you are not able to find time for the things that you truly want to do, then there is something wrong with the prioritizing that you are doing. So, pehle apne mind mein apni priority set kariye, both professional and personal. Write that down and you will see your life will be much more easier. Does that make sense? Yep. Okay. Any more questions? There are some questions around, okay, somebody's written, thank you, thankful for getting beautiful life. Tips for networking. Yeah. Okay. So this is my favorite topic, actually, networking, because like I said in my session, there is a huge power of networking. Bada zaruri hai networking karna. So some tips to network are that first of all, enroll yourself into various professional networking forums. It's very important. And these days, because of everything going online, there are many online platforms of networking. There are many WhatsApp groups. Just spend some time, research on the internet and you will find many groups today. Shayad COVID se pehle itne online groups nahi the networking ke liye, but with everything going online, even networking has shifted online, which is a really good thing for ladies. All the events are happening online. So you don't really have to go anywhere after office. You just need to log in from your smartphone and that's it. So do some research on the internet about various professional networking forums relevant to your field and become a part of those. The second very powerful way to network is use LinkedIn extensively. Are you people using LinkedIn? Are you people on LinkedIn? Thumbs up for the people who are on LinkedIn. See, very few people, we are not even there on LinkedIn. We need to be on LinkedIn if we really want to professionally network with people. So first thing today, go home and create your LinkedIn profile. And on LinkedIn also, bas profile bana ke chhod nahi dijiye. Bahut sare log yehi karte hain. Profile banaya aur chhod diya. Uske baad, 2 saal ke baad khol ke dekha, achha kya ho raha hai. Get into the habit of regularly following people on LinkedIn. People who are relevant to your profession. There are many things to learn. contribute in the form of articles, in the form of blogs, contribute your opinions on what others have written on LinkedIn. It's a very powerful tool to network. I'll tell you today, being a consultant, being a trainer, I get 50% of my work from LinkedIn, people who follow me on LinkedIn. That's the power. Because it is a huge community, huge. Every working professional today is on LinkedIn. And through LinkedIn only, you people will get contacts of these networking forums that I'm talking about. And you can join these groups and become a part of these groups. So number one, become a part of networking forums. Number two, be active on LinkedIn. Okay? That is, in today's time when we are not necessarily required to go after office for networking events, this is the best time to actually become a part. Ghus jaiye in groups mein. It's actually a very powerful tool to build your connections. Okay? And stay in touch with people. That is the third advice that I'd like to give you. When you meet a professional from your industry, you go to a conference, you attend a conference, you exchange business cards. Uske baad kya hota hai? Wo business cards hamare visiting card folder mein hi pade rehte hain. Hum kuch nahi karte. That's the third tip. When you meet professionals from the same industry, your seniors, some mentors you meet, or even people who are at your level or even junior, make an effort to reach out to them after the event. Stay in touch. Keep a conversation going. Otherwise, there's no point. Aap card leke aa gaye, card rakh diya, uske baad kaun hai, kaun nahi hai, next event mein pata bhi nahi chalega. So stay in touch with people. Okay? So those are some of the tips that I would recommend in times of today to do active networking. Explore the internet, explore LinkedIn. It's a very powerful community. Okay. Any more questions? Okay, there is one question on team development. How to get work done from the team? Do you people struggle with that? Anybody? Yes, no. Yes, thumbs up, no, thumbs down. We are deciding. We are discussing and deciding whether we struggle with it or not. Do we struggle with it or not? Is getting work done from team members? We struggle with it, okay? One person struggles with it. What about the rest? Okay, no worries. Let me talk to you about a little bit about team management. Now, what happens is, ek style hota hai leadership ka, right? Now, I don't know what challenges you face in team management. Is it around getting the work done on time? Or is it around getting your team to listen to you? What is it? First or second? I hope you're typing something on the chat. What is the concern around team getting the work done? Okay. So getting the work done is a challenge. Ke time pe kaam complete nahi ho pata hai. So usme what we need to do as senior people, as people who are managing a team, is first of all, you need to identify whether your team member has the capability to do that work or not. A lot of times we dump work on people. Hame upar se kaam mila hai, humne apni team ko de diya kaam. Without realizing whether my team member has the capability to do this job or not. And then when the team member is not able to do it, then, you know, we blame him or her. Now, there are two problems here. One problem could be the ability problem, the skills problem, ki usko kaam karna aata hi nahi hai. And the second problem could be an attitude problem. Kaam aata hai, lekin kaam karna nahi hai. Now, if it is an attitude problem, then you need to delve a little more deeper and see that why does this person have an attitude problem? What is the issue? Is this person not motivated enough to do his work? Or does this person take it too casually? Ki chalta hai, attitude hai. Isliye hai aisa? Or is it because this person thinks it is an easy job? So let me just sit back, take it easy. So you have to first know as a supervisor ki aap kaam kyun nahi karwa pa rahe. Ya to us bande ko kaam aata nahi hai. Agar kaam nahi aata hai, to bhi aapki responsibility ye hai ki aap usko sikhaye. And if you can't teach him, partner with your HR department and organize a training course for this person so that this person's skill can improve. Wo to aapne kar diya solve. Zyada difficult hota attitude problem. When they have an attitude problem, that is very difficult to change. Now, there also, in my experience, whenever you have a difficult colleague, a difficult reportee, what has worked for me in the past is to build a great relationship with such people. Wo isliye nahi sunenge aapki baat kyunki aap unke boss hain. Wo isliye sunenge aapki baat kyunki aap unse acche se baat karte hain. You are concerned about them. You ask them about their family, about their children, about any problems that they have in life. I'll give you my example. When I went to Kota, jab main apne industrial training karne gayi thi Kota mein, I was working with workmen, workers jo hote hain. Now it is very difficult to work with them kyunki us level pe aap kuch samjha nahi sakte. They have a set attitude with which they work. To sabse pehle जरूरी होता है उनके साथ एक बॉन्ड बनाना. द सेम थिंग गोज फॉर अ डिफिकल्ट एम्प्लॉई एज वेल. फर्स्ट इन्वेस्ट इन द रिलेशनशिप, इन्वेस्ट टाइम इन द रिलेशनशिप, एंड देन बिकॉज वंस दैट पर्सन हैज अ बॉन्ड विद यू, ओनली देन दैट पर्सन विल बी ओपन टू हियर व्हाट यू वांट टू से टू हिम. अदरवाइज आप कुछ भी बोलते रहिए, आप डांटिए, आप डपटिए, जो मर्जी करिए, वो काम नहीं करेगा. ऐसे एम्प्लॉयज के साथ सिर्फ कोचिंग और काउंसलिंग ही काम आती है. ये डांटना, वार्निंग इश्यू करना, ये सब नहीं काम आता. इट विल फर्दर पुल देम डाउन एंड दे विल हैव अ आई डोंट केयर एटीट्यूड. सो एज अ बॉस यू हैव टू हैव द कोचिंग एंड काउंसलिंग स्किल्स ऑफ सच पीपल. स्टिल इफ दे डू नॉट इम्प्रूव, देन ऑफकोर्स यू हैव टू टेक एन एक्शन. You have to escalate it to your boss, or you have to escalate it to HR. HR then puts them on a performance improvement plan. Then HR has its own processes, right? But at your level, you have to first make that bond with your people so that they can trust you. Ye trust establish karna bada zaruri hai. Half the times we have problems with people because neither they trust us nor we trust them. ना उनको हम पे भरोसा होता है ना हम उन पे भरोसा कर पाते हैं. तो ये जो भरोसे वाला काम है, ये एज अ सुपरवाइजर आपको पहले करना पड़ेगा. यू विल हैव टू बिल्ड दैट ट्रस्ट इन देम सो दैट दे लिसन टू व्हाट यू हैव टू से. अदरवाइज तो इट विल बी अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट एवरी डे एंड यू विल फेस द ब्रंट ऑफ इट बिकॉज यू आर नॉट एबल टू गेट वर्क डन. सो इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स ऑन योर परफॉर्मेंस एज वेल कि आप काम नहीं करवा पा रहे अपने नीचे वाले लोगों से. So getting work done from people is also an art. It doesn't come to everyone. You have to know the style of people working under you. What motivates them? What encourages them to work hard? What they don't like? And accordingly tackle with the people. Does this give you some clarity on people management? Yes? Okay. Okay, any more questions? Any more questions here? Yes, no, okay. All right, great. So I think there are no more questions. So it's time for me to log off. Thank you so much. I truly hope you enjoyed this session. And if there are any questions that you still have, you want to reach out, you know, personally, you can, HR, you know, has my coordinate details. You can take my coordinates from them and reach out to me in case you want to you know, discuss any questions personally. I'm open to that as well. Thank you. Thank you for your time. And thanks for giving this opportunity.
This is Rupali Shivani.
Yes, Rupali. I can hear you.
Yeah, yeah. It was nice interacting with you on this forum. I think I'll shut.
Okay. I have positive vibes. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Bruna. It really was very nice to talk to all of you. I truly enjoy leading sessions where there are only women, because I wish it was a physical session. I could come down. But nevertheless, I hope I was able to help on a few things to the best of my abilities. Thank you very much, and all the best to everyone. Thank you. Cheers.